Take a moment, remind yourself to take a moment and find yourself. Take a moment and ask yourself if this is how we follow. According to the Anxiety and Depression Association of America, most people feel anxious or depressed at some point in their life. Losing a loved one, getting fired, having test anxiety, going to a new place. Those are examples of anxiety or depression. Speaking from experience, you get anxiety a lot of times from doing stuff that you are not comfortable doing.
Based on research from the Newfield Foundation, the amount of 15 to 16-year-olds who have reported frequently feeling anxious or depressed has doubled in the last 30 years. Dr. Anne Hagel of the Newfield Foundation explains the social shift that this data shows.
Back to sort of the mid-1970s, even through to the middle of the 1980s, a lot of people would have left school at 16, gone out to work, maybe stayed on a little bit to do some vocational courses, but essentially there was a youth labour market, and there isn't today. So what we see is a real difference in how young people between the ages of 16 and 18 are spending their time, because so many more of them are in education, and that might stretch on.
What changed was the amount of time adolescents spent in school. This gradual shift has changed the adolescent experience from structured work to an increased importance on individual choices and how to spend their time. Adolescents, now more than ever, are expected and pressured to maintain their education and productivity, thus the increase in anxiety and depression. There is a need for the education of how adolescents can deal with these overwhelming thoughts.
According to M.T. Whitty, a psychologist that did a study on coping and defending, age differences and maturity of defense mechanisms and coping, the youngest participants used significantly less mature defense mechanisms and significantly more immature defense mechanisms.
Escapism and avoidant coping are characteristic of the less mature coping mechanisms. The habit of adolescents to use escapism to cope can take the form of media, like investing themselves in a fandom.
Coming from fandom life, which is shows or movies or comic books or anything that you feel passionate about, this clip is Jared Padalecki explaining why the season 8 finale episode Sacrifice is so important to him. Because it is explaining depression and suicide, which he struggles with daily.
That to me really solidified why I understood Sam. Because I, Jared, without getting too deep, have always had a complex about disappointing people or feeling like I'm disappointing people or I'm not enough or I'm not good enough. And so to hear Sam, to see Sam do it in a script form was really powerful to me. And this was 176 episodes in, right? But to read something and go like, oh my God, like they're writing my fucking life story.
Moments like these allow fans to find comfort in the meaningful representations of themselves in media.
This overwhelmed fan is at a Supernatural convention thanking Jared Padalecki for his AKF campaign, which is Always Keep Fighting, that helps for mental illness and depression.
People make a difference and have people like you, Taylor, make a difference for me. So thank you. And thank you guys.
Recently, shows like Steven Universe have taken the chance to expose their audience to the experience of anxiety and shown how to overcome these feelings in an episode called Mindful Education. The episode was related to a coping mechanism called detached mindfulness. It comes from a theory called metacognitive therapy, or MCT, that was developed by Adrian Wells and Gerald Matthews. It is characteristic of psychological disorders like anxiety and depression for thinking to become difficult to control and biased in ways that lead to a worsening in emotional suffering. Because of this, Wells upholds that MCT can be used to manage the ways people with anxiety get stuck in these harmful thought patterns. John Kabat-Zinn from the Massachusetts Medical School puts it this way.
It's the awareness that arises through paying attention on purpose in the present moment.
The episode chooses to show mindfulness through song.
Close your eyes. Okay. Breathe.
Something you did that felt to be charming. Things that you say are suddenly swarming. And take a moment and find yourself. Take a moment to ask yourself if this is how we fall apart. But it's not.
Towards the end of the episode, the protagonist, Steven, who's overwhelmed with his past traumatic experiences, is comforted by his friend Connie. The scene solidifies the lesson of mindfulness.
I didn't want to hurt anyone! I'm sorry! None of them would let me help them. I had no choice.
It's okay.
No, it's not.
But it's okay to think about it.
It feels so bad.
That's okay too. There was nothing else you could have done.
I don't want to feel this way.
You have to. You have to be honest about how bad it feels so you can move on. That's how it was for me.
Like Steven in this episode, everyone will experience the awful, overwhelming feelings of anxiety at some point. Because of this, it's important that people understand and see examples of coping. For media like Steven Universe to educate these ideas to adolescents and give them exposure and an outlet for these feelings of anxiety is so important.
I'm here.